In high school, he would hand out mixtapes to his fellow classmates. Today, this local DJ is still playing music in the school halls, only this time, it's in an effort to give back. Rodney Hot Rod Washington is one of Chicago's very own. At Michelle Clark High School on Chicago's west side, it's lunch hour. Students are called to the auditorium for a surprise event.
This is probably going to be bananas in here.
If you have perfect attendance this month, we'll bring special guests to your school. We'll come turn your school up.
It's called the Pep Rally Takeover. Or on this day, Lunch Takeover. Rodney Washington, better known in Chicago as DJ Hot Rod, is making a special appearance at Clark School in hopes of motivating and rewarding students for their hard work with a club-style dance party.
He came, did a lunch takeover. Kids went crazy doing lunch, but we did it as part of an attendance incentive.
Power 92 is on my line.
A popular DJ at Power 92 Radio.
You want these tickets? I got you.
Rodney keeps a busy schedule, working 6 days a week and DJing home games for Notre Dame's men's basketball and football. DJ Hot Rod still makes time to give back, though.
See, I told him, don't put no bleachers out. I want nobody sitting down.
In 2013, he and some friends came up with a way to put a new spin on the old-fashioned high school pep rally by turning it into a dance party.
So we had three schools. We had Julian High School, we had Hammond High School, Indiana, and we had Morgan Park. Those are the three schools we had. And we did a test run with D-Lo, Stunt Taylor, a couple of Chicago artists. And they came to the schools and the kids went crazy.
A huge success. This school year, he expects to host more than 30 pep rallies in Chicago area high schools.
But I try to get so many schools in, even though I know I'd be tired, but I don't want to miss no moment. I don't want to disappoint no kids or anything. Like, man, you didn't come to my school.
And after a big test, DJ Hot Rod often pumps up the volume at his school rallies by bringing along special guests, like local artist Kid Ken and Chance the Rapper. Although his rallies are packed with fun, he also takes the opportunity to speak with the students about serious issues.
I'm asking one time, if you love your life, put your hands up.
Including gun violence and bullying. He recalls one takeover rally where the students were so affected by violence, they didn't want to dance.
We didn't play no music. We got to the point where we got to just sit and talk with y'all because I think a few kids got shot the day before. And we was like, man, what's going on?
Throughout his shows, he regularly offers words of love and encouragement.
You got to think, it's kids that go through so much stuff at home. Like, they need that time to relax and burn some energy or listen to some music.
And the students enjoy the well-deserved break.
This was a time where they just happy and excited, everybody just feeling good in a good mood.
They bring people together, you know, they have fun, they connect, they meet new people.
The popularity of the pep rally takeover is growing fast, with dozens of schools requesting to book him. Volunteering his time, the schedule during the school year can be grueling. But he admits he too reaps the benefits of these dance rallies.
Just seeing kids smile and just being around my friends, this is like my...
And everyone is grateful.
For him to come and do that and volunteer his time, his music, his energy, it's phenomenal for us.
Rodney DJ Hot Rod Washington. He's one of Chicago's very own.
Last week, DJ Hot Rod posted a video from another pep rally takeover from Lindhop Elementary that's in Broadview, Illinois. In the clip, students are singing and dancing to the new Billy Ray Cyrus song. Cyrus himself shared the clip and wrote, "This is what music is all about." The video now has over 2 million views. DJ Hot Rod says he hopes this idea will someday gain worldwide attention. Right now, he's looking for sponsors so he can branch out to other schools.
Very nice.